Hallo allemaal en welkom bij alweer een nieuwe video. In my last video with Silas, where I tried 5 different ways of riding, I told you that I was going to explain some of my favorite bitless bridles in my next video. So today we are going to do just that. I have 4 different bridles ready for you to explain how they work and which one I like the best or a little less. And my mom, who is now filming me, will be demonstrating the bridles with Pasha. So we will use Pasha's head as a model to show you how it works when you pull the reins, how it works when you make sure the bridle is fitted right. And then I will film my mom riding and she will also tell you what she thinks about the bridles. You will have 2 opinions and another horse, a new horse. This video is to show you my opinion and to tell you my opinion on the bridles that I have. There are many more bridles that you can choose from, but this is what I have at home and this is what I have experience with, and so this is what I feel comfortable telling you and sharing with you. I am sure that you might have another opinion if you have ever tried one of these, and that's totally fine. This is just my opinion and what I like, and yeah, we can just see how it works on Pasha, and then you can tell me in the comments what you think about the bridles. So let's go.
Is it pretty? Oh, is it sexy?
So we just walked to the bridles. We are in the tech room and here are my 4 bridles. So this is the Nalanta bridle. This is my Hackamore. This is, well, I don't really know the name for this in English, so it's crossed underneath the jaw, so I'm just going to call it a crossed underneath the jaw bridle. The cross jaw bridle. And then we have the side pull, so we will start with the Nalanta bridle. Okay, before I forget, I had a lot of questions about what neck rope I was using. I have 2 Nalanta neck ropes. They are both slightly different from each other. This one is almost all rope and a little piece of leather that you can hold onto while you're riding. And this one is like 60% rope and 40% leather. And you can choose to hold this. So this is around the neck, or you can choose to hold it the other way around, whatever you prefer. Yesterday I was riding with this one, but I like them both a lot. I would say these are the best, but you don't have to be restricted to rope or leather. Like this is leather, but this is made by Justine van den Berg and she made this as a gift for me, and this is all leather and it's a little bit more stiff of course than a rope, and you can also use a rope that you put on your halter to lead your horse. You can be very creative as long as it's not too thin, because if you pull really hard that might be a little bit annoying for your horse, but like there's so many options, you don't have to restrict yourself.
Well, today I am going to be the one riding, demonstrating all the different bridles with my Pasha.
Okay, maybe we can get him and then we can start with the first bridle. Love the yellow legs.
Yes.
Silas.
Okay, now I'm going to try all these, but the reason I really like to ride with the Hackamore most, with Pasha, is because he kind of gets excited, especially riding outside, and then this is a little bit more control, a little bit more break. So this is going to be a challenge, a little bit. I'll just, you know, I don't know how this works. So, well, in the side, I don't know. I just have to try them. Okay, I'll try the Nalanta bridle first.
Yes, let's do it.
So this obviously is too loose and it's too low because the cartilage is starting here. You can see when I press that his nose goes like this. So the most ideal way to put this bridle is like 2 fingers here. Also, a lot of people tend to do the, especially the Hackamores, very loose. And then what you get when you pull is they can go like this. So don't be too careful, because then the bridle won't have any use. now you can see, you can easily put two fingers underneath and it's still, he can still chew and he can still do what he wants, but the wheels won't turn anymore.
Yeah, you can still eat cookies.
You see that when he chews, this is still getting loose, so now he has all the space to move his jaw, but the bridle is now fitted how it should be fitted. So here you can see around two fingers and it's not too low on the nose. Good so! Good so! And now the reins are on the side of the slide hackamore. What side would you like it on, Mom?
No, I like that.
And I will explain a little bit more about the how this works in the riding arena. So what happens when you pull the bridle in the slide hackamore setting is that the wheel starts turning. So you can see the bridle moving here, here and here. Look. So you have pressure on behind the ears, on the nose and underneath his jaw. That's what happens when you use this Glückshut, this sort of hackamore style. Ah, Pasha. Like this. And when you put it here on the side pull setting, the pressure and the movement of the bridle is mostly on the nose. Of course, you can see it everywhere, but the most pressure is on the nose. Oh, right, right. Yeah, right. Yeah, yeah, right, yeah.
There she goes. Oh. Oh. Yeah. It's a pleasure. Are you ready for the next bridle?
Yes!
You can do it. Fits like a dam.
Okay, this is the hackamore, and what I really like about this bridle is that the nose piece is very wide. So that means that if you pull your reins and the shanks go down, this is very wide, so the pressure is very divided on the nose. You also have hackamores that have a very thin nose band, but I mean, that has to be very sensitive for a horse. So the wider the nose band, the more evenly the pressure is divided. So when you pull the reins of the hackamore, what happens is, as you can see, it goes like this. It pulls here and here and here. A little bit the same as in the Lancer bridle, but then it's the pressure is a little bit bigger because obviously the shanks are a little bit longer, so that makes a lot of difference. Yeah. What is very important with this hackamore and with the hackamore in general is that you should not make this too loose, because what happens is the shanks will dangle down, and when you pull on the reins, they will go either like this or they will just be floppy. So when it's too loose and the shanks dangle everywhere, it's not working the way it should be, and then it's sort of like some kind of a side pull idea because the whole effect of the hackamore is gone. So don't be too careful with your bridle. Again, two fingers is really good. Here from the side, it's about three this time. The higher, it could be a little bit higher, but this is also good for Pasha because as you can see, there's still a lot of space on the nose. And let's try this one. Yep. He's big.
Yes. It's like 170.
Almost. So I found the name for this bridle, and it's called the Crosslink bridle, It is from FRA, just like the previous bridle with the hackamore. I will leave a link down in the description. I have used this bridle quite a long time for Q, but eventually I still went to the hackamore and to the Naranja bridle, just because I like the system more. So what happens is when you pull on, when I pull on this rein, you can already see what's happening. This is the rein, so it goes cross-linked. Can you maybe film this? Cross-linked underneath the jaw. You see that this is the rein that I'm pulling on. And then when I pull this rein, look here, it goes, do you see that?
Yeah.
Into the jaw. So it's kind of like when you pull on the left rein, the head goes like this. And you pull on the right rein, the head goes like this. Pasha has never tried it, and Q is the only one that has tried this bridle. And he did good on it, but he responded better to the hackamore. I also feel like if you pull both reins, the release underneath the jaw is not as good as with a hackamore. So when I go like, when I pull, it kind of gets tight, but when I let go, like it stays kind of the same. And with a hackamore, it's just like when you pull, it gets tighter, and when you let go, it's literally like more loose. So this bridle is not my first choice. I have a friend that really likes this bridle, so it's obviously also what you prefer yourself. But for my horses, what's wrong? For my horses, this is not the bridle, but it could be the bridle for your horse. This is really just like, you have to try that out.
I think the bridle looks really good on Pasha. It fits him.
Everything looks good on my Pasha.
Okay, there she goes. This is long leg. Oh! I mean, you're 90% leg, and then the rest.
So this is the side pull. You have many Pasha, wat lief van jou! It's pretty straightforward with this one. When you pull, the pressure is on the nose. It's that simple. There's not much action going on behind the ears, behind the jaw. It's just on the nose. And as you can see, this nose band is pretty thin, which means that it's a little bit sharper when you... So as you can see, the nose brand is pretty... The nose brand... So as you can see, the nose brand... So as you can see, the nose band is pretty thin on this bridle. You also have them with wider nose bands. It just depends on what you get. And the thinner the nose band, the sharper the way the bridle works. So it also depends on how strong you are with your hands. If you pull all the time, no bridle, no bitless bridle is gonna be nice. But if you're very gentle, of course, everything is better. Oh, so.
Yes. Oh, sorry, yeah. Okay, last bridle. Okay, you ready for the neck rope?
Oh! Can we try?
Yeah, just okay. Even, you don't have to trot, just like walk or something.
Yeah.
Do you want the neck rope with a lot of rope? Do you want the neck rope with a lot of leather? Or do you want the leather neck rope?
Okay, Pasha. Neck rope. Never really done it. So, we'll see what happens.
Of course, now when you start riding with a neck rope, they start. Yeah, it's so. Yeah. Oh! That was good with the neck. Can you imagine he just starts bolting? Yeah, well, you use your body a lot. Oh my god, it's not stopping. Oh, ah! Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
He likes his freedom, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Goed gedaan, Paja.
Okay, I won't mount.
Go play. They're having a happy hour.
What's happening?
Too much. Too much horses. Too many.
Oh, whoa!
Oh! Rita.
Hi, Rita!
Oh!
Okay, so I've tried all the four bridles and this is what I think of it. It really doesn't make a lot of difference to Pasha what I ride him with. He just responds to every bridle about the same. But I think when I go outside on a trail ride, then I think I would still prefer the Hackamore. But otherwise, they are pretty nice and good to ride with. Really, the only one that I really not prefer to work with is the Crosslink bridle, because it's kind of complicated to put it on, really. And because he has the long hair, it all gets a little bit stuck. It doesn't feel like it releases that good when I let go of the rein. So although he did respond very well in the arena, I don't think I would use it. It's a little bit too complicated. No.
And how was the neck rope?
The neck rope was fun, and although all the other horses were like a little bit crazy, he still remained pretty calm. But you know, he just goes really low with his head, so I have this feeling like, oh my god, you know, I don't have really much of a break. But he did respond pretty good for the first time that I did this, and yeah,
I agree.
So okay, so first of all, I'm very proud of my mom for trying all these four bridles. As she said, Pasha is not really that complicated in an arena. He thinks it's all fine as long as he gets a cookie and as long as my mom is being positive. It does definitely depend on what kind of horse you have. For Silas, he doesn't really like the, well, he doesn't like the cross link bridle at all. The side pull for him, because it's such a thin nose piece, is also not really comfortable for him. So he responds better to, for example, the Nalanta bridle. It does really depend on trying things with your horse. Just because Pasha was easy with everything, doesn't mean all the horses are easy with everything. That's really a matter of getting your hands on different bridles, borrowing them or whatever, and trying them on. So the most important thing is to try different bridles and give them more time. Not just ride once and be like, oh my god, it didn't work out. Just give it some time to get used to it, because your horse also needs to get used to it. For me, my favorite bridle is always the Nalanta bridle, because you have these different settings, then the Hackamore, and then the side pull. For example, with the Crosslink bridle, as my mom said, we both feel like the release is not as obvious. Like, when you let the reins go, of course the pieces on the jaw relax a little bit, but with the Hackamore, letting go is letting go. And with the Crosslink bridle, we both feel like the tension stays a little bit, but that's different for everybody. A friend of mine loves it, I prefer something else, she doesn't like the Hackamore, so I can talk about this for hours, but let's just face it, just try the bridles. Not just these, you have so many more different bridles that you can choose from. Try to find your information online, try to talk to people that have a lot of knowledge about it, and just try it out. Just literally try it out, and you will feel which one will work for you and your horse, and which one will definitely not work for your horse. So if you have any questions or any stories about talking about bitless riding, the bridles that you've tried, or if you have any questions about the bridles in my video, leave them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe, and then I'll see you in my next video.